YouTube, Black Metal ASMR. I know it's been a long time, but I just have the motivation right now. So while I have the motivation, I decided to make another Smells Like a Collection video. And this one is going to be about my Creed cologne collection. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. It feels strange to be back, but it feels good to be back. A lot has happened. Mostly good in my life. But this video is gonna be old school. I'm using my Samsung Galaxy S6 Edge that I bought like 3 years ago. But after I finish this introduction, I'll take my camera or my phone into my bedroom and record on my bed, because that's all that matters. By the way, I plan on visiting Serbia later this year as well. It's a really small country in Europe, over there by Hungary, Kosovo. I don't know. I forgot the other. It's really small, that's all I remember. I plan on going there later this year. I don't know when yet, so if you live there and you wanna meet up, then let me know. Okay? But that's it. Yeah, I'm gonna make this video for y'all, show y'all the Creeds I have so far, and hopefully y'all will like it. And hopefully this video will be effective. Alright. I'll see y'all in the bedroom. Bye. Okay, I'm back. So, this is my entire Creed collection, with the exception of this. This is a special mention. Okay. Now, this one, a few years ago. This one is called... Let me see if I can... there it is. Phoenicia Northwest. Focus. There. Well... Phoenicia... Far in West, really. Phoenicia Far in West. But years ago, I heard about this cologne coming out, and I wanted to buy it, but I did not have money back then, so I could not buy it. Yeah, but this is a full-size bottle right here, and I think it was like $45. But the reason I bought this, it's because, I mean, I bought it a few months ago, but the reason I bought it is because it has skunk smell in it. Yes, it has the note of skunk. And when I saw that when they first released this, I was like, oh, I gotta buy it. So, I don't know, I bought it and I actually like it. It smells good, but it's not something that I would wear every day. I mean, I have to be in the mood to wear this one. Yeah. Unfortunately, there are no reviews on YouTube for this cologne. I don't know why. But yeah, that's just an honorable mention. So. Now. This one is Creed Sublime Vanilla. This is not the actual bottle. I have a full-size bottle, that I actually made an unboxing video of years ago. Yeah, but this one, it smells like, I think in the video, the unboxing video, I said it smells like an Givenchy pie on steroids. It's just straight up vanilla. Okay. Oh, it's not focusing, dang. There we go. Now, this is just a sample bottle, so when I use this up, I'll go to my big bottle and fill this back up from my big bottle, okay? Because my big bottle does not have a sprayer, it's just a pour, like you have to pour it. Okay. And hopefully I have enough memory on my phone to record this. I miss the good old days when Samsung had removable memory cards. Now this one, it's Creed Millicene Imperial. I'm very sad because I'm almost out. Look at that. So I'm gonna have to buy a new bottle soon, a big bottle. But this one, I think this was created in 1995, I think. But it's a timeless fragrance. Okay, it smells like, it's fruity, but salty at the same time. A lot of people say it smells like salty watermelon. But the reason I say this is timeless is because it doesn't smell like a certain time period. You know, sometimes you smell a cologne and it smells like it's from the 80s or 90s. This doesn't have that vibe. It just smells timeless. Okay. And this one is Royal Oud, okay? I actually wasn't going to buy this, but one time years ago, some very rich man, we became friends for a short while, and he said, "Hey, I want you to try this cologne out." So he gave me a little sample of Royal Oud, and man, like, it felt like when I tested it, it transported my mind to a different dimension. That's how good this stuff is. And I bought this bottle. When I bought this, 3.5 years ago, I think. I don't know. But I don't use it very often because it's really rich. Okay, and I don't know. It's just, this one is a very, it's a mature fragrance. I'm not saying like it's an old man fragrance, but when you wear this, you smell like you are able to protect society. I don't know, it's a very fatherly, courageous fragrance. And the best thing, the closest thing I can say this smells like is oak moss. Like when I was a kid, there's a big oak tree in my backyard and there's green stuff growing at the bottom of it. Oh, sorry, I didn't know what it was. And my mother told me one day, she said, "Oh, Luke, that's oak moss." And when I was a kid, I would always scratch that oak moss off the tree. I would scratch it with my nails and I'll smell it because it smelled good to me. But this reminds me of that. This one is Creed Aventus for Her. I bought this, when I bought this, maybe a year ago? Almost a year ago, I don't know. Yeah, it was almost a year ago. But this one, I was kind of skeptical at first. So I went to the store and I tested it and fell in love with it. And I told the saleswoman, I said, "I'm gonna buy this for myself." And I did. But it's very, it has a very strong peach smell in it. but it's not like straight up peach. It's like peach, but in the background you smell a little bit of florals and a little bit of powder and a little bit of like honey slash syrup. So this one's really good. It's in complete contrast to Creed Aventus. This is white, this is black, okay, then it has gold, Aventus has silver. This used to be silver on the older bottles, but the newer bottles have black. The fluid on the inside is like a golden color. This fluid is clear. Yeah, but sometimes I wear both of them at the same time. I spray my Aventus on, then I put a little hint of Aventus for her. Now this one is Creed Aventus. Like, everybody's heard of this one already. And yes, it is as good as people say it is. Some people don't like it, which is great. It just means there'll be less people that smell like this. But yeah, this is my daily fragrance. One of the main reasons I like this one though is because I cannot smell it. And that's a good thing to me because I don't like being able to smell myself. Okay? So I put this on, then like 5 minutes later I smell nothing. But this one, if you're not familiar with it, I'll try to describe the smell to you. It's like pineapple mixed with bonfire smoke. That's it. It's like pineapple and bonfire smoke. Oh, and musk, yes. But yeah, I don't know. It's just like you just have to try it, okay? But the stuff lasts for a long time. Like, you spray it on your body and people smell it on you like 15 hours later. It's crazy. Out of all the Creeds I have, this one is my least favorite. Creed Aerolfa. Now this one, it doesn't smell bad. It smells good. Oh wait, let me, one more thing. I'll go back to this Creed Aventus. By the way, this is a new bottle design, okay? This is 3.3 ounces. Let me see. Her. Three, well, 3.33 fluid ounces, 100 milliliters. Now, their old, older bottles are kind of like this one. Well, it says 4 ounces. Oh, well, you can't see it. Well, my shirt says 4 ounces, 4.0. I mean, yeah, 4.0 ounces. 120 milliliter, and it's more of a boxy shape, okay, more of a square shape, but they reduced the size to 3.33 milliliter. I'm sorry, why are you saying 3.33 ounces, 100 milliliter, but increased the prices, so I'm not very happy about that. Now, back to Aerolfa. This one, it doesn't smell bad, but it smells like dishwashing liquid. Okay, dishwashing detergent, however you want to call it. But the only reason I bought it is because it's just different. It doesn't smell like any other cologne I've tried before. And I just wanted to add it to my collection. I also love the name Aerolfa. This is a combination of some of the family members of Creed. It's, ER comes from Erwin, OL comes from Olivia FA. I forgot who this one was, but it's a female. I forgot who she was. I forgot her name. But once this one runs out, I will not buy another one. Now, Virgin Island Water. This one is special to me because this one, when I first tried it, like, I forgot what I was going through, but I was having a horrible time. And I ordered a sample of this. This was years ago. Ordered a sample of this through the mail, and when I tried it, it put me in such a good mood. I could not stop smiling. But this one, it smells like lime and coconut. It smells like lime and coconut. And if you're familiar with Ylang Ylang, it smells like that too. It's best to use this one during the summer. You can use it during the winter, but like, it's such a fruity smell that it's more good toward the summer. And it does last a long time. A lot of people say, oh, this only lasts 4 or 5 hours, but no, it lasts really 8 hours. But you just, after about 4 or 5 hours, you stop noticing it, but the people around you do notice it. So this is really built for the summer, and has great performance in the summer. Yeah, but if you don't like coconut, don't get it, because my sister, she doesn't like coconut, and one time I went to her house wearing this, and she was like, "Luke, you smell like coconut. I don't like it." But when it's mixed, when she notices that lime, that kind of changes her mind a bit. Now this one, this is the most recent one I bought. I bought it maybe a month ago. This is called Creed Pure White Cologne. It used to be called Original Cologne when they first created it years ago, but they changed the name. I don't know why. But I've been ordering samples of this all the way back when it was called Original Cologne. And I love it. I don't know. Like, the only negative thing I can say about it is that out of all of these, this one smells more like a cologne. Like, do you understand? The other ones, they just smell like a smell. Okay? People smell them and they don't think of a cologne. They just think of things that smell good. This one, it smells straight up like cologne. The best way to describe this smell is that it's a very powdery, but not like baby powder. It's like a really, really expensive, like, if you can imagine the most expensive powder in the world, that's how this one smells. Okay. And I really love this bottle design. I'm not a fan of gold, but the way they designed this bottle, it makes it look attractive to me. I don't like this little dangle thing hanging off of it. I can easily remove it because it's only held on by this white rubber strap. But I'll leave it on her anyway because I want it to be complete. I don't want to have something incomplete. Now, the size of this bottle, I don't know, maybe three. Let me see. I forgot already. Oh, they're 2.5 ounces or 75 milliliters. Another reason I don't like this thing hanging off is because when it makes contact with the glass, it makes noise, and I don't like that sound. Another ASMR artist, her name is Brittany ASMR. She loves the sound. Like sometimes in her videos, she has two glass objects and she intentionally, she intentionally makes them contact each other to make that sound. I really don't like that sound, but she loves it. Other people love it, so hey, if you like it, then maybe you'll like that. Yeah, I plan on getting maybe four or five more Creed fragrances. And I don't want y'all to think I'm some Creed fanboy or anything. Well, okay, yes, I am. I am a Creed fanboy. Creed is my favorite fragrance house, but I'm not gonna like a Creed fragrance just because it's Creed, okay? Like, there are some that I find disgusting, like Silver Mountain Water, Green Irish Tweed. What else? Love in Black. Like, they have some that I really don't like. Oh, and by the way, this one, Virgin Island Water, that was my father's favorite one. Yeah, he loved it. One time he asked me to buy him a bottle, but he said their own name. He asked me to buy him Silver Mountain Water. So I bought him that instead. And then when he got it, he's like, "No, I meant the other one, the one with coconut." I was like, "Oh no." But I didn't have any money then because I spent it all on Silver Mountain Water. Yeah. But I eventually sold that Silver Mountain Water to somebody on eBay, I mean, on YouTube, actually. Yeah. Yeah, a couple of people messaged me, say, "Hey, you wanna sell that?" I said, "Okay, yeah, I'll sell it." So, and he was very happy, so that was cool. I used to have another one called Chevrefoil, I think. I think that was the name of it, but it was honeysuckle. I eventually sold that one because it smelled like it was from the 80s. It did what it was. Oh no. I actually have to go now. My phone just told me that I have almost no minutes or no memory left. So thanks for watching. Y'all be safe and happy. Okay, bye.